So we've been running the Volterra out of Station 8 on Madison's east side for about 18 months. We've purposely decided to put it here at Station 8 for multiple reasons. Some of it is the territory. It's a really diverse territory, meaning that we have residential, we have apartments, we have businesses, we have the interstate. This truck is doing roughly 12 to 15 calls a day, not to mention the four seasons that we have here in Madison. So it's been really pushed hard for 18 months. It's been a really good true test here at Station 8. So when we first designed this truck and worked with Pierce, there's some hesitation from the get-go. We didn't want our operations to take back step to the technology because we weren't really sure what the technology, you know, what level it was at. We didn't want any kind of a slowdown. We can't really in the fire service, right? When you respond to a call, you need to know where all your equipment is. You need to, you know, the hose needs to lay out the same on every truck. We want to be able to pump this truck the same as all our other trucks, because lives truly are at stake. And so when a firefighter or a driver come here to operate this Volterra every day, we really wanted to make it feel like any other truck that we have. I'm here today confident. Obviously, we have a fleet full of Pierce vehicles. So the daily in and outs didn't really change a whole lot about preparing people. There was, I think, about 5 to 10 minutes our people are up and running on this truck, which is really, really impressive. There's no hesitation whatsoever. There's no extra steps that the driver has to do to make this operationally effective on fire scene or an EMS call. So it's really, really similar to all the other Pierce trucks that we have in service. And that to me was really important. One of the things that I love about this whole project is we had some input with Pierce when we went to like design this fire truck, is that we wanted this truck to look like a fire truck. That's one thing that we hear all the time when people see me at FDIC with it last year. They're just amazed. They're like, we would never know that this truck is an electric fire truck when it's driving down the road. The Pierce Volterra has really performed well for us. We've been able to, like I've said before, we've had this truck running for 18 months. So today it's like 8 degrees outside. We've had degrees in the 90s. So we've been able to see those cycles of how the outdoor temperature works. The Volterra's worked well through all those different climates. I'm really, really confident, otherwise we wouldn't be moving forward to buying the next Volterra. In the past, we've been pumping this truck off the diesel mode. The truck does have the capabilities of pumping strictly on battery. The technology has been so solid for us, and the one that we purchase comes that we're gonna try that out. So I am super confident that this technology is where it needs to be at this current state. I think whether or not it's winter, we get a lot of comments about that. Like, how does this battery hold up in the winter? Well, it's 8 degrees here today, and this truck will run smoothly throughout the whole day. It'll come back and get charged up between calls. And again, I anticipate that we'll never use the diesel motor throughout a day span. This truck has never ran out of battery in operational mode throughout a 24-hour period. They come back, they're usually fairly short calls. They go out, they're out for 15, 20 minutes on the majority of our calls, but not every call. Sometimes they're out for hours and they come back, charge it up, and it's good to go. There's never been a delay in due to the battery. So the technology, like I said before, the technology is really there. And I anticipated throughout the years to come, more research, more design, more input from other fire departments is really gonna take this technology even to the next level.